स्टार्ट करें बात। ओके, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। वी आर डिलाइटेड टू होस्ट द वेबिनार फॉर यू। वी हैव अ गेस्ट स्पीकर मिस्टर निलेश शाह, एमडी एंड सीईओ ऑफ कोटक महिंद्रा एसेट मैनेजमेंट कंपनी। विदाउट टेकिंग मोर ऑफ योर टाइम, आई वुड नाउ रिक्वेस्ट मिस्टर शाह टू स्टार्ट शेयरिंग हिज व्यूज विद अस।
हाय, वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। Obviously, this is the most unprecedented time for us. We have seen in the past medical crisis like Surat plague, like Ebola, Zika, SARS, bird flu, swine flu. But we have never seen a medical crisis like coronavirus, which shuts down half of the world. We have seen financial crisis, 91 Harshad Mehta, 97 Asian crisis, 2000 Ketan Parekh scandal, 2008 subprime, 2013 taper tantrum, 2016 demonetization. But this is the first time where we are seeing a perfect combination of medical crisis moving to financial crisis, moving to real life crisis, and all three coming together. This is the perfect storm, which we hope and pray will be the first and last ever witnessed by us. There are companies which are getting decimated in the current situation. Companies in hotel, tourism, travel, aviation, retailing, multiplexes, small and medium enterprises, they are all facing tremendous pain and tremendous pressure in current situation, as the revenues have dwindled and the costs have continued. This situation is undoubtedly going to result into job losses, salary cuts, rental renegotiations, and cost cutting of a nature which we have never seen. This will be absolutely necessary to survive the downturn. Obviously, companies in sectors like telecom, power, healthcare and infrastructure, pharma, online distribution, food processing, food distribution will suffer minimum damages. But overall, there will be significant cost to the economy. What could be that cost? This is a child's calculation. Don't take it at face value. This is for direction, not for magnitude. Our total GDP is $3 trillion. If all activities remain shut for 1 month and every month had equal output, then the loss is 350 divided by 12, $250 billion. We know that power consumption is down about 24%. So effectively, half the activity is continuing and half the activity we can assume to be shut. This is only assumption. That means our loss is $125 billion. However, economy is not like power. You switch on and it comes, you switch off and it goes away. There will be something called restarting cost. That's why it's 125 plus. What's the restarting cost of economy? We don't know. It could be 50 billion, it could be 100 billion, it could be 150 billion, but there will be definitely some cost for restarting. Against that $125 billion plus restarting cost, we will have benefits of lower oil prices. Oil prices are down $40 billion. Our oil import down $40 billion this year if prices persist at current level. If we can replace made in India goods to made in China goods, which we are importing to the extent of $20 billion. To that extent, growth gets created in India, not in China, and we can save that money. Effectively, we will be left behind with $60-65 billion plus restarting cost. Restarting cost, we have no idea. but that needs to be managed through monetary stimulus, fiscal stimulus, and foreign direct investment. That 60 billion plus restarting cost needs to be managed by RBI, by central government, and by getting foreign capital from abroad. Let's first talk about current situation. Well, this is the chart which you can look at carefully. On x-axis is medical solution, early to late. Y-axis is RBI support and government support from low to high. Today, as we talk, there has been a vaccine developed by University of Oxford under leadership of Dr. Sarah Gilbert, which has gone into human trial last Thursday. This vaccine is being manufactured by Serum Institute Pune. Even before approval has come, they plan to manufacture 50 lakh doses and keep it ready. In case that vaccine is successful, we will see by September this vaccine being commercially made available. In that kind of early medical solution, along with fiscal and monetary stimulus by RBI and government, which is very, very high, we could see recovery like V-shape. April, May, June, July, August, September, we will go down. But October, November, December, we could start bouncing back sharply. The most unfortunate scenario will be medical solution, which emerges very, very late, and fiscal and monetary stimulus is subpar. In that scenario, our recovery will be L-shaped. We will fall sharply, but we won't recover at all. Between medical solutions and fiscal and monetary stimulus, bottom of the market and bottom of the economy, both will be made. We all know the pain of coronavirus. Are there any benefits to Indian economy? I think there are some benefits which we can capture. Oil prices, I talked about, it can help save India $35 billion, depending upon our import and what oil prices prevail. Lower trade deficit, I talked about, if Indians desist from buying Chinese goods and replace that with Indian goods, the jobs which we were helping create in China will get created in India, and to that extent, economy benefits. Third is the fiscal and monetary stimulus. RBI has cut interest rates and pumped liquidity, but that liquidity is frozen in bank. It's not moving to borrowers. The rate cuts have happened on policy level, but has not moved into market yield as much as it should. And in that process, we are seeing that fiscal and monetary stimulus is having slower effect, subdued effect, rather than major effect. RBI has already started working on transmitting rates as well as money from banks to borrowers. And as they become successful, monetary stimulus effect will be visible in economy. On the fiscal side, government has not yet announced large fiscal stimulus like other countries, but I'm sure it is on its way. And that fiscal stimulus combined with monetary stimulus will also support economy. There are two big benefits which can come to India, which is through foreign direct investment and foreign portfolio investment. Our government, Ministry of Finance, has worked very hard to ensure India's benchmark weight goes up in MSCI Emerging Market Indices and FTSE Russell Indices. Most global investors look to invest in a country based on what's their weight in indices. If weight is lower, there will be lesser inflow. If weight is more, there will be more inflows. Clearly, increase in MSCI weights and FTSE Russell weights will bring between $3 to $6 billion from here till June 30th and August 31st. it is likely that MSCI will be operational before June 30th and FTSE will be operational before 31st August, bringing billions of dollars into country, and which is why today you can see markets getting supported. The second and the bigger opportunity is foreign direct investment. In 1980, India and China were of similar size. They became manufacturers to the world. We were left behind. China is today 5 times bigger than India. They became manufacturers to the world. We were left behind by a margin. Now, companies across the world are looking to shift out of China. They are worried about the rise of China. They are worried about how China has conducted coronavirus episode. On the other hand, India gives access to as large market as China in terms of numbers. It is a democracy. And the image of India has taken upward journey of several notches in recent time. Two of the oldest civilization, China and India. China gave Wuhan virus to world. India provided hydroxychloroquine tablets to the world. And if University of Oxford trial becomes successful, it will also provide vaccine to the world, which will contain coronavirus. Ek ne dard diya, dusre ne dawai di. Ek ne jakham diya, dusre ne marham diya. Bachane wale ki kimat marne wale se jyada rahegi. There are companies who wants to move out of China to India. If you can bring those companies into India, it will help India grow at a much faster pace in the days to come. Let me give you an opportunity how big this is. Samsung is a Korean chai ball. We are all familiar with it. They make in India items like TV, fridge, AC, mobile phones, and sell it in India. Their turnover is about $10-12 billion in India. Samsung went to Vietnam much after it came to India. Vietnam is 1/10 the size of India in terms of GDP. Samsung's turnover in Vietnam is 6 times bigger than India at $62 billion. Vietnam has grown faster than India courtesy Samsung, despite Samsung coming to Vietnam much later than India. Samsung makes in Vietnam and sells all over the world. They have $62 billion turnover, contributing 28% of GDP to Vietnam. The value of Samsung to Vietnamese economy is more than value of Indian government to Indian economy as a percentage of GDP. We have to ensure that we bring this large companies from China to India. We help them flourish. We help them grow. And they carry India along with them. Coronavirus has damaged our economy substantially. But there is benefits of lower oil prices, lower trade deficit if we replace made in China goods with made in India goods. The fiscal and monetary stimulus will support Indian economy in the days to come. There will be more foreign portfolio flows and foreign direct investment flows if we get our house in order. Combination of this can help India recover if and when medical solution emerges. As I mentioned earlier, and I want to repeat, this is a medical crisis metamorphosing into financial and real life crisis. And unless we find a medical solution, these problems can't be wished away. The bottom of the market and economy will be made when medical solution emerges. In current economic situation, what should we do as an investor? Should we invest in equity market? Answer is yes. Someone can question, but there's so much of uncertainty. Why should we invest? Well, market always moves between uncertainty and risk. When there is uncertainty, prices are attractive. Good price and good times don't come together. Good prices are available only in bad times. Today, market doesn't know what is the cost of lockdown. Is it 50 billion? Is it 500 billion? They have no idea. Is the lockdown for 6 months or 6 weeks? They have no idea. Hence, it is swinging from positivity to negativity, from fear to hope, from greed to fear, and which is where you have good prices available in the market. One can say, Nilesh bhai, but the P ratio is high. Of course, P ratio will be high because this year, how many companies will make profit? Most of the companies' profit will be suppressed significantly in this year. So P ratio will look high. But you have to evaluate this company's on historical valuation on broad parameters like market cap to GDP ratio. The 10-year average market cap to GDP ratio is 76%. Today, market cap to GDP ratio for India is 52%. 76 is average. We are somewhere at 52. Certainly, this is below historical average and hence a time to buy. The bottom of the market was made at 43% market cap to GDP ratio in October 2008 and 45% market cap to GDP ratio when Nifty touched 7,600. Clearly, these are levels to buy, and hence we recommend people to be overweight equity because good price and good times don't come together. What should we buy? Small cap, mid cap, large cap? Well, traded market is giving you time travel machine. You can go back 4 years to buy large cap stocks. Nifty index is today trading at 2016 level. You can go back 6 years to buy mid-cap stocks. Nifty mid-cap 100 is available at 2014 levels. You can go back 9 years to buy small-cap stocks. Nifty small-cap index is available at 2011 level. Rarely in life, market gives you an opportunity to go back 4 year, 6 year, 9 year to buy stocks. This is one of the exceptional period where you can time travel. But because small caps have fallen to 9 year low, that's not the reason you should be buying small cap. You have to look at your risk appetite. If you can bear volatility of small and mid cap, if you're aggressive investor, go for small and mid cap. If you're a conservative investor, go for large cap. If you are average investor, go for mid cap. Don't chew more than what you can bite. Next question which comes, how do we make investment? Since you are saying these are levels to buy, should I buy everything tomorrow? Answer is no. Please don't make that mistake. We don't know when medical solution will emerge. We don't know how much fiscal and monetary stimulus will be given. Market will swing between hope and optimism on one side, fear on the other side. So you can't invest in lump sum, even though levels are attractive to buy, because you want to average yourself into the market. If you are a Kumbhkarna investor who wants to buy today and forget for 14 years, then yes, you can look to buy lump sum. But normally I have found only those Kumbhkarna who say, I want to invest for 15 years. And after 1 week, when prices are down 5%, they will call back. So that's why we recommend people to invest on a multiple tranches rather than at one go. In the uncertainty market, when market doesn't know cost of lockdown, when lockdown will be lifted, it will be appropriate to invest in multiple tranches, let's say 10 or 15 tranches, so that you can average yourself into the market. On the other hand, the balance portion you can keep with us, keep with you, and invest when you are sure that economic activity will resume normally, as there is no need for lockdown because of the medical solution. Once a combination of drug is available, a standard protocol to cure coronavirus patients, once a vaccine is available to prevent occurrence of coronavirus, then you could put half the money at work. When you are investing in uncertain market, you have to do multiple tranches. When you are investing in hope market post-emergence of medical solution, you'll have to be quick. and you'll have to invest in 2-3 installments. This is the time to be overweight equity, considering historically cheap valuation, but the approach has to be calibrated and gradual. Next question then comes, Nilesh bhai, koi sector mein daale ya diversified rahe? My recommendation will be to remain diversified as things are rapidly changing. And in this time, a diversified portfolio will be less risky. Of course, it can give lower return. Risk adjusted, it will be far better than concentrated risk. Next question which comes, is there any other asset class which are better compared to equity? Yes, gold looks attractive. Normally, when interest rates are low and liquidity is high, gold does very well. Gold prices have moved in November 2008 from $750 to $1,875 in September 2011 in a low interest rates and high liquidity environment. Directionally, gold prices will get support of high liquidity and low interest rates from 2020 onwards for some time to come. There is third potential reason for gold prices to go up, that is potential buying from China. Today, China's FX reserves are invested in US dollar, euro and yen kind of global currencies. In US, there is a class action suit filed against China. A state has already launched compensation claim on China for COVID-19 cost. In Germany, a newspaper has written a bill for levying charges for COVID-19 cost on China. Now, whether this thing materializes or not, China will be significantly worried that their money could be confiscated to pay for this COVID-19 claims. It's likely that they will shift some of their money from US dollar, euro, yen assets into gold. If they start buying gold, that will be substantial boost to gold prices, and hence some allocation to gold is advisable. How should we invest in gold? Physical gold, gold ETF or gold bonds? Well, if you're looking to invest on a 5 to 7 year horizon, gold bonds are better because they give you 2.25% to 2.5% coupon. But if you're looking to invest with 1 to 3 year horizon, gold ETFs are better, even though we charge nominal fees for it. This is how we see current situation, unprecedented market, difficult time, but we need medical solution and strong fiscal and monetary stimulus to overcome current situation. And then we must capture foreign direct investment for companies moving out of China to India and ride on them to be part of global supply chain management. That will improve India's economy significantly, and India's market also will improve along with that. I'll be happy to take questions.
Thank you so much, sir. I am sure our customers have enjoyed this session. We have compiled certain questions and request you to address them. The first one is, which are the sectors that could see immediate bounce back? And which are the sectors that we should stay away from?
In terms of sectors, please.
Yeah, sorry. Please go ahead, sir.
In terms of sector, please remember that in financial services, one guy can be Yes Bank, other guy could be HDFC Bank or Kotak Bank. So it's always the promoter which matters and not the sector. In fact, let me show you this chart. Let's assume there are good promoters, bad promoters. And let's assume there are good businesses and bad businesses. Good business is a business where return on capital employed is higher than cost of capital. Bad businesses are businesses which earn 6% but pay 8% interest on loans and hence go towards bankruptcy. Good promoter works for you and doesn't cheat you. Bad promoter takes money from you and uses for personal benefit. If you are in good promoter and good business, over long term, you will make money undoubtedly. If you are in bad business and bad promoter, you are unlikely to make money. If you are in good business, but with very bad promoter, it at best is a trading opportunity, because when chances come, the bad promoter will take you for a ride. If you are with good promoter in a bad industry, again, it's a trading position, because someday industry will overcome promoter's effort. So try to be in good businesses with good promoter. Now, what are good businesses? Let's look at chemical sector. Over the last 2-3 years, India has increased its market share in global chemical markets from 2.5% to 4%, as China has downgraded from 43% to 39%. Indian companies have now broken into reliable supplier list, tier one supplier list. BASF apparently buys $1 billion worth of chemical from Indian chemical market across multiple players. There are companies which are now getting multi-million dollar contracts. So chemical sector looks good based on the growth opportunity. The second sector which looks good is contract manufacturing firms. These are the companies which makes TV, fridge, AC, electrical appliances, and gives it to global brands. And this brands then distribute this product under their brand name. Today, contract manufacturing firms are providing product for local markets. Now they are getting inquiry to supply to global markets. Global markets are 10 times bigger, 20 times bigger, 50 times bigger than local market. So contract manufacturing firms which gets global order and be part of global supply chain management will do well. Look at behavior changes which will happen because of COVID-19 lockdown. Earlier, when we thought of entertainment, it was movies in theater, concerts in stadiums, cricket matches in stadium. Now, when we talk about entertainment, it is in home. Instead of seeing movie on theater, will we get addicted to seeing movie on Amazon and Netflix? Who knows? The shift of entertainment from outdoor to indoor will be one factor to watch, and companies which benefits over there will do very well. आज अगर आपको कोई बोले फैमिली से कि गर्मी बहुत है, आप एक एसी लगा दीजिए, शायद आप ना कहेंगे। पर अगर कोई कहे कि एक आइसक्रीम खिला दीजिए, गर्मी बहुत है, शायद हम हाँ कहेंगे। लो टिकट कंज्यूमर स्टिल कंटिन्यू टू सी ग्रोथ बिकॉज पीपल विल कंटिन्यू टू स्पेंड, बट बिग टिकट कंज्यूमर स्पेंडिंग विल गेट डिफर्ड। इफ टूडे यू हैव टू बाय एन ऑरेंज जूस, यू विल से सिंपल सा ऑरेंज जूस दे दो, बट अर्लियर वी डिडंट माइंड बाइंग अ कैलिफोर्नियन ऑरेंज जूस विथ फोर्टिफाइड विटामिन्स एंड कैल्शियम एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ। द वैल्यू फॉर मनी ब्रांड विल डू वेल कंपेयर टू उबेर लग्जरी ब्रांड। मोस्ट पीपल विल डू डाउन ट्रेडिंग ऑफ देयर ब्रांड। कंपनीज विच आर प्रोवाइडिंग वैल्यू फॉर मनी ब्रांड्स विल डू वेल। कंपनीज विच आर इन अबेर लग्जरी, दे विल नॉट डू वेल। If you look at savings, most people will now save money for a rainy day, because this 21 days, this 40 days are becoming difficult to survive. As savings pool increase, benefit of that increased savings pool will be felt in banks, mutual funds, insurance companies. Coming to insurance companies, will people go to buy health insurance policy quickly? And more people will get addicted to buying insurance policy, health insurance policy, quite likely. General insurance companies which provide health insurance business will do well. So there are many sectors which will do well because our behaviors are changing. There are many sectors which will do badly because our behaviors are changing. TCS is India's largest IT company. It announced that out of 400,000 employees which have, 75% of employees, they would like to move on work from home side. Now let's assume they are going to put 3 lakh people on work from home. Today they have roughly 100 square foot per person. That's about 300 lakh or 3 crore square foot commercial assets. Now, if 3 crore square foot commercial properties are vacated by TCS, what will happen to commercial property? Who will develop? Who will rent? So we are going to see substantial changes because of this behavior. And anyone who can predict those behavior and start investing will do well.
Thank you, sir. The next question is, at what level Sensex and Nifty are expected to find the bottom?
Many thanks for asking this question because you think I'm knowledgeable to answer that. But trust me, if I had that knowledge, I wouldn't be working in Kotak Mutual Fund. I will be sitting in Nassau, Bahamas, doing intraday trading on Nifty and enjoying life. I don't have any such knowledge. That's why I have to work. भगवान को भी शायद मालूम होगा कि नहीं मुझे पता नहीं निफ्टी और सेंसेक्स कहां पे बॉटम बनेंगे. कीप दिस चार्ट इन माइंड. मेडिकल सॉल्यूशन एंड फिस्कल एंड मॉनिटरी स्टिमुलस विल डिफाइन वेयर मार्केट्स बॉटम विल बी मेड. इफ हिस्ट्री इज एनी इंडिकेशन अराउंड 40-45% मार्केट कैप टू जीडीपी रेशियो मार्केट शुड बॉटम आउट. बट प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट judgment is based on only financial crisis. This is medical come financial crisis. If we don't get medical solution, the downside of market is more. If we get quick medical solution, maybe market is already bottomed out.
Thank you. The next question is, do you expect the government to announce more economic stimulus packages to breathe life into the slowing economy?
Undoubtedly, yes. See, there are two kinds of companies. Ek company jahan pe cash flow mismatch hai. They have assets, but they don't have liquidity. That problem can be solved by monetary stimulus. But there are companies whose survival is at risk. They have revenue zero. Cost continuing, assets not there. They need fiscal support so that they can survive the downturn. So companies who have cash flow problems will get managed through monetary stimulus. But companies which does not have basic cost structure to survive will require fiscal stimulus. And I expect government to announce fiscal stimulus like any other part of the world. Our government is providing stimulus in smaller lots, smaller batches, smaller doses. Globally, people have done big bang approach, but eventually we will provide fiscal stimulus for our economy, for our industry.
That was really insightful, sir. Thanks. The next question is, do you expect any revival in FII sentiment going ahead?
Undoubtedly. Jaisa maine pehle bataya, ek country ne dard diya hai, dusra dawai de raha hai. Ek jakham de raha hai, dusra marham de raha hai. Why will people not appreciate this? Ek company hydroxychloroquine tablet bhej raha hai, aur bhagwan ne chaha to we will start sending vaccine also. Why will people not appreciate it? I think pre-COVID-19 and post-COVID-19, world will recognize India far more. Second, as I mentioned earlier, in MSCI India, in MSCI index, Emerging Market Index, India's weight will increase by about 8% by 30th June. And in FTSE Russell, India's weight will increase by 17% by 31st August. As your index weight goes up, more flows will come from index funds and also from active investors as they realign their portfolio to reflect India's increased weight. So FPI sentiment will improve for India and we will see good flows, partly because of index weight and partly because the way we have done the work. I was talking to Financial Times today and I told them that look at India. Our health infrastructure is worse than Italy. Our population is probably 25 times Italy. We got coronavirus patients on the same day, 30th Jan, 31st Jan. Today, cumulative number of deaths in India is less than 1,000 on coronavirus, and daily deaths in Italy is more than 1,000. Despite lower population, despite better health infrastructure, Italy is in worse position than India. We have managed protection of life very well. Now the same we have to transfer towards protection of livelihood. If we can manage livelihood by providing appropriate fiscal and monetary stimulus, and we get a little bit lucky on medical solution, FPIs will perceive us far better. हाँ, इसमें थोड़ा एक रिस्क है कि हमारे वहां पे कुछ लोग हैं जो इंडिया को नीचा दिखाने की बहुत कोशिश करते हैं. Now we'll have to ignore those people and we have to pray that those guys don't become successful.
Right. My last question will be, what is the new normal for the markets post lockdown?
Tough question to answer. I think in some sense everything remains the same, and in some sense everything changes. When I say something will not change, it's basically focus on your fundamentals. It's basically keeping open mind to process data and taking corrective action. These things will never change. On the other hand, the world is going to rapidly change. Work from home will become real. Increased savings will become real. Downtrading of brand will become real. We'll probably go to shampoo bottle to sachets model. As people lose their buying power, instead of buying bottle of shampoo, they will buy sachets of shampoo. And everyone will have to convert their services, their product offering from bottle to shampoo, bottle to sachets. Entertainment will move from outdoor to indoor. Social distancing will become norm. Physical process will move towards digital processes. All kinds of things will come into play, and that will show us a completely different world. From an investment point of view, one will have to factor in leverage, which many of us had forgotten. And clearly, while the basics of investment remains the same, people will move towards big is becoming bigger and better concepts. In automobile, we have seen few large companies surviving. In telecom, we are seeing few large companies surviving. In PSU banks, we will see the same thing. Hence, this is the time to focus on big is becoming bigger and better kind of concept.
Thank you. It was such an insightful session indeed. On behalf of Kotak Securities, I'd like to thank you for your valuable input.
Thank you. Stay safe, stay healthy, take care of your physical health. Market will give enough opportunity to cover back on financial health.